I'm sharing my screen. Before that, may I know, Miss, may I know who all are the front end developers and what is their expertise?
Actually, Ms. Divya and Naveen and Ragni and Rajni and myself, actually. We all are like have worked in UI part also and as such in backend also. So after this, we will be having this aggregation, like who will be focusing more on UI part, but as such, we know React also and jQuery framework related things we know.
Okay. Sure. That's fine. In e-commerce, we have created a lot of documents actually related to UI part. I just take the documents and go through that step by step, and we will get a deep idea actually. Before that, I will tell you what all are the libraries we are using in means our UI development. Okay. First one is React.js. React.js is from Facebook. We are using this one for creating the complex screens. Yeah. And other thing is we are using Material UI. I think people might heard about the Material UI. They are following the Google design guidelines. And they have created many base components actually. Those components only we are using, and we are wrapping that component, and we have created a few more. This is the UX library. Here we are having all the basic components, and some advanced components also we are having here. And coming to the project management, means Lerna. Lerna is a tool actually. Lerna is a tool because in the e-governments we are having around 20-21 models actually. Maintaining each model, it will be difficult from one application actually, means one CRA application. Okay, CRA means React.js having some CRA commands, create React app. Using one React application, it's very difficult to handle multiple projects. That's why we are using the Lerna library to manage multiple packages actually. Okay, this is the Lerna we are using for managing multiple projects. And this is about the UI actually, main libraries we are using in the UI part. And I think people might know the Redux part also. I think who are worked on the React, they might aware of Redux also. This we are using for state management. Currently we are not using any jQuery part. Whatever is there, ES6, ES7, ES5, that code standard only we are using. This is for maintaining the whole application in state. Any questions still?
No, actually. Means Lerna part, will you be okay? It's a for package management, you are saying. Means you are,
yes.
Actually, one thing is there in UI, na, there are multiple folders, UI app, V2, UI app, and then we are having the Rainmaker web. So, will you explain that part, why we are having different folder and what
yeah,
is
yeah, I will explain.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. Okay. I will explain. Yes. I think this is clear, right? This is the, we are having multiple other third party libraries also, but main libraries I'm just explaining actually that we that is used in our project.
So Lerna is something like, as we do in Maven, some project structure it follows or something like that for packaging also?
Yes. We know NPM, right? NPM, Node Package Manager. Actually.
Right.
NPM. npm we can create our packages and we can host it for the outside world. Actually outside world also we can make some packages private also, correct, right? For example, if we want to test that package before hosting to the npm level or private level, if you want to test that package, means it's very difficult. Actually we have to host and fork. Actually what Lerna will do is it will give the packages from local only. We can create our packages and it will miss act as a npm only. Actually means we can create multiple packages and we can interlink, and Lerna will take care of linking those projects. Actually I will show you in going forward.
Okay.
Our project is, means I think you also got the access. Frontend is our project actually. It depends upon which state or which part you are working actually. For example, if you are working in the product, there is a branch is there that is called release actually. Release. So this is the product branch actually. Whatever product team creating new features, right, that will be there in this branch actually. Okay, for example, state related we have made some few more branches actually. For example, Rhinemaker UK, new, it will have Uttarakhand related UI code actually. Okay, like that we can see for the Punjab. Maybe this release master. This is for Punjab actually. This is for Punjab. Like this, we have Bihar, and we have demo environment. Okay, and we have created recently e-pass application also. That related branch also will be there. Okay, like that we have bifurcated actually. But the release this branch I shown, right? Release 2020 V2. This is the product branch actually. Okay, once the product release some new feature, we will get the code from this branch and we will merge into our state branch actually. That is the process. Currently I am using Git for desktop. This is the open source tool from the GitHub. Okay, who are comfortable with the command line, they can go for the command line. Okay. This tool is having many features actually, merging and stashing, and we can see the history and all actually. Means what all the history is there, who has committed, and what is the change, and what part they have added. Many things will be there actually. Okay, that's why I am using this Git for desktop. Okay, this is supported for currently Mac and Windows. Who are using Windows, they can download the Git for desktop from GitHub official website and they can start using it. And first step is we have to clone the repository actually. Means we have to clone the repository wherever the project is there. Okay, if you are already opened installed the Git for desktop, it will show you option opening desktop. Yeah, you can just click on that thing. It will clone and it will open in the Git for desktop. Otherwise you just copy the clone, means this URL, and go to the your Git for desktop and just copy paste that URL and click on clone. It will clone the whole project actually. Yeah, currently I already cloned the project, that's why I just take that copy only and show you how to use. This is the current project, okay, of the front end project. Whatever you will change, right, that will come in this side actually. Changes, just now I changed something that will show you here, and you have to write some commit whatever the commit name is, whatever changes you have done, and you can write the description and you can click on commit to the branch, whatever you, it's mentioned here, we have selected here. That branch, that will go there actually. And also you can see the history here. For example, if you currently might be, you might be working for different state or different means different state, right? That time what will happen is, first you have to switch to that release, this release 2020 branch, and going there, and you have to create a new branch. For example, on top of that PB release, okay, I want to create a new branch. You just click on the PB release master and make it as something like a space state related branch, whatever you want to. I just showing you Karnataka release. It will be a branch, and then if you click on the publish, it will list the branch to GitHub. Okay, after that you can start using this branch actually. For example, you can, on top of this one also, you can create other branches also. Means, for example, feature wise branch actually, or developer wise branch, you can create, and you can go further. I just change my credential. It just published the batch. After that, if you go back to the GitHub version, that branch will be there actually. Okay. Here on top of this Karnataka, you can create your feature branch actually. Okay, feature branch and the developer wise branch. You can click on the new and select the Karnataka KR release master, and you can create new branch here, and you can start working on that actually. This is the strategy we are following currently for different state actually. I will move back to the Punjab. Currently I'm working in the Punjab state. Okay, I have I will show from that branch only. Okay, any questions, you know?
No, it's clear actually.
Okay. Now what we can do is, I just, it's good, I don't get this one. Okay. The Git for desktop will give you option to open the project in the IDE, whatever you are using actually. Currently I'm using Atom. Okay, I can use Visual Code or other, whatever you are comfortable actually. You can click on this one, it will open in the editor. Okay, after that what I would suggest is, if you open three command prompt, it will be easy to run the application actually. I will tell you why we need three command prompt actually. Currently we have two application, one is employee and one is citizen actually. Okay, so sometime developer might be working on the both the application. That's why if you have two window, you can open the both the application and you can run that application actually. Okay, well, another one is, for example, as I told you, our application is divided into multiple models actually. If you see currently, I just open the new command prompt, I will show you. Okay, currently the front end is our repository, right? As I told you, okay. Here multiple folder and files are there, okay. We no need to worry about, as a UI developer, no need to worry about other folders. Apart from web folder, we no need to worry about other folders actually, okay. It's just to, for other purpose actually. So if you see the build, right, build as we seen in the this DevOps session, right, build is used for creating the new pipeline and other part actually, okay, that is not needed, okay. And if I come to the web one is there, right, web folder will contain all the front end related projects actually, okay. This is the web. Let me switch back to the Punjab branch, okay. This will have all the web related projects, okay. Currently here also we no need to worry about all the folders. We just need the Rainmaker folder actually. Rainmaker is a running application that we are seeing in the demo environment or other states actually, okay. We need only this folder, okay. Here only I have set up the Lerna project setup actually. Here we can see the readme, we have added the architecture diagram and how to run the project, everything we have added, and even we have added the reference part actually. You can check this reference part. Okay, this is a Rainmaker is a project we needed currently for the running the citizen and employee application. Okay, other than Rainmaker, some of the folders are used actually. Okay, as we have the APK also, correct, right? We have mobile version also. Okay, for mobile version, we have some folder Rainmaker WebView actually. Okay, this is for whatever Android Studio means our project code is there, right? That will be here actually. Here you can open this project in the Android Studio and you can build, already project is there. You just, if you want to build for your state, you can just open the this project in the Android Studio and you can build it actually. This session also I will cover in the next tomorrow, I guess. There is another session, how to build the APK and how to generate the APK and how to use this project actually. That I will cover in tomorrow session. Currently, as you asked, right, the Rainmaker is a folder. Other folders we have to clean up actually. Soon we will clean up the other project that is not related to the UI part, that we will clean up. Currently, you can focus on these two, Rainmaker and Rainmaker WebView. Okay, these two will be used for one for web project and one for mobile project. Any questions for the project structure? Is it clear now?
Yeah, it's clear.
Okay. Here we are having the Lerna the setup actually. Okay. Currently, let me open the IDE. Currently, I'm using Atom. This is the Rainmaker is a folder. Here we are having this is the Lerna project setup actually, Lerna project setup. Okay, here we can maintain, currently as you've seen in the React, right? React means we will create one project, that means using the create React app, the project name we will write and it will create one project, right? Like that, we are having multiple CRA project actually. We are having multiple CRA project. You can see here, multiple create React app projects are there. Correct, right? You can see trade license is one CRA project and universal collection is one CRA project. Universal collection is miscellaneous collection and the PGR is one CRA, property tax one CRA, and many models are there actually. That for managing those models, okay, we are using the Lerna actually. As we know, we have two views. Correct, right? We have one is employee view, and Currently, I'm opening the Punjab gate.
Mali, what is CRA? Okay, okay. Got it.
Yeah, CRA, Create React App actually. This one is there, right? The React.
Got it. I was not knowing the short form actually. Sorry.
Okay, that's fine. Currently, we are creating single project, right? For example, if you want to build a React project, means we will use CRA command, create React app command, and we will put a project name and we will create a project, correct, right? Currently, we are having multiple models actually. That's why we need multiple CRA project, correct, right? Multiple CRA project we needed. And also those multiple CRA project, we will render inside citizen and employee actually. Okay, citizen, this is citizen view. And this is an employee. Here, employee I already logged in actually. That's why it's logged in. Okay. Currently, you can see here compliance, property tax, M collect. These are the multiple models, correct? Right? And here also, if I log into the citizen, the development mode 1 to 6 is a hard coded this OTP you can use and you can log in. But first time you have to register actually, that is the criteria. Okay. Here you can citizen side, you can see these are the models actually. Compliance, property tax, trade license, fire NOC, these are the models. Okay. And as employee side, these are the models, whatever I am showing here. Okay. That means dev packages, whatever dev folder, packages folder is there, right? These are the sub models to citizen and employee actually. Okay. Whatever we are seeing here, whatever seeing a property tax and fire NOC, those are the submodules that will be there in the dev packages level. Yeah, that will be there in the dev packages folder level actually. All the submodules. Okay. All the dev packages we are taking and integrating inside the citizen and employee application. Yeah, that main application will be there in the packages. Main application will be there in the packages that will contain the main application citizen and employee. And citizen and employee, even that is a CRA application actually. Citizen and employee, you can see a CRA boilerplate. Same boilerplate we use for citizen and employee. Yeah, lib I will explain you afterward. Okay, what is the purpose of lib? And asset you can ignore actually. It's no more using. We are not using this asset folder. We can just ignore that asset folder. Coming back to the project structure.
So Murli, this in Lerna we mentioned all the CRA apps like to be bundled to each other and how the citizen app will use those models. Like, do we mention all that in Lerna?
Hi, yeah. That I will come. That okay. Point I will come to that point. How okay. to integrate and how does Lerna? What is the work of the Lerna? That also I will show you. Actually.
Okay.
This is our front end architecture actually. Currently here few more modules are there. We haven't added. Currently we are having around 14 to 15 modules in the microservice architecture. We are having 14 to 15 modules. Currently we can see only in 7 modules here actually. We need to update this document with those modules also. Currently you can see this citizen and employee is a main application that we are seeing here actually. Okay, inside citizen and employee we are running PGR citizen and HRMS, ego trade license, NPT and other models, whatever we are using. Okay, and there is a two packages, custom packages we have created actually, ego UI kit and ego UI framework. These two packages we have created. That packages will have something like common components, common util functions, and common Redux structure, and a common configuration. those will be there in the Ego UI kit and Ego UI framework that will be shared to citizen and employee and other models actually. Okay. And these other sub models will be used in citizen and employee as a NPM package. Okay. I will come to that part. This is the architecture. This is the architecture of our UI. Okay. If I come back to the folder structure.
Only this Confluence you are sharing it, Sankalan page, is it private or it's accessible to everyone?
Which one?
This one, Rainmaker UI app structure.
Okay, okay. So currently it's a private actually.
Okay.
I think I'll send to share this repo. She will take care of sharing this Confluence actually. After that, you will have all the access. Here we have written the document, how to use the UI project and how to create new project and how to use it actually.
Right. So, okay. For other documents we have, I couldn't find it, so just wanted to confirm.
Yeah, yeah. Currently in the Git, we have some high level document. It's won't have much deep actually. Whatever we have created each model wise and framework level document, right? That is there in the Confluence. I will inform Lelson to share this this project only. You will get all the documents.
Okay.
Here, as I told you, dev packages will contain all the packages, okay, so sub packages, and packages will contain citizen, employee, and lib section. Citizen and employee is the main application. Lib, I will tell you what is the use next lecture. Okay, and next thing is, okay, I'll tell you about the Docker actually. For example, a citizen and employee is the main application, right? Main application. For that, we have to create our Docker setup actually. That will be there in this Docker folder. You have to write the Docker code here. Because it's already written actually. In the future, if you want to create a new application, okay, what you can do is you can create a new application, okay, and you can write the Docker setup here actually. That is right here, and the Nginx is routing will be there here. And node models, anyhow, it's this node model is related to learner level actually. For example, if I want to build a learner project, what all are the NPM packages we needed? That will be there in the node level. This .es code is generated from the Visual Code IDE only. No need to worry about this Visual Code folder. And packages, as I told you, that will contain the main application and the libs actually. Currently, this will contain the ignore files, and here we are having learner setup actually. What are the packages we are using, that we have to mention here. What is the path we have to mention here actually. This is the learner setup, and after that we have the package.json. Okay. It will have some dependencies that is related to learner, okay, and some dependencies are dev dependencies, and some are normal production dependencies also. Okay. This is the dev dependency, and this is the dependencies. And here you can see lot of we have created many script actually, custom script actually, running each model, running citizen and running employee. We have created the custom scripts actually. That will be there in the script level. Might be in the normal CRA application, you might be seeing this much only, right? This much only, start, build, and test, and inject, and those things, correct, right? This is the learner project structure. That's why we need multiple commands to run each individual modules and Running the employee application and citizen application, we need multiple comments actually. That's why we created these many comments. I will come back to the comments. I will take one example and I will explain you going forward actually. Okay. This is about the project structure. I think the project structure, it is clear actually. Okay. Is it clear? Anything I want?
Yes.
You want to? You can consider all our CRA project actually. Okay. All our CRA project, and we are using Lerna to interconnect each project for development purpose actually. Currently, if I go to the citizen packet.json, you can see here ego NOC. Correct, right? Ego NOC, ego trade license, and these are the dev packages will come as a NPM package inside citizen and employer. You can see ego UC. These are the custom these are the modules not there in the NPM level, correct, right? We have created these custom modules, okay, that will be injected by Lerna. Currently you can see here JSON path and material UI, these are the third party libraries we are downloading from the NPM and we are using here. These are the custom one we have created. Lerna will take care of injecting this one inside the Flow model. Okay. Here also we can see the custom models. Okay. Like this we are injecting actually. Currently you can see this diagram. As per this diagram, you can see these are the dev packages, right? That we are injecting inside employee and the citizen. Okay. And even I told you these are the two library packages actually. That also will come here. Ego UI framework, Ego UI kit, those are the libraries. And even I told you there is a dev packages that is also using Ego UI kit and Ego UI framework. That can also, we can see, we can go to the module. We can see here there is a dependency on Ego UI framework. You can see here there's a dependency of Ego UI framework. Like this diagram, we are architected like that. Okay, if any questions, I can take that question. I can go to next one.
So this Ego UI framework is in dev package only, right?
Yeah, dev packages, yes.
Okay.
Which is this application that you are using to browse all these folders and files?
This one, yeah, this is a Autumn is a open source editor.
Okay.
Open source editor. You can use this. This is from the this is open source editor actually. Can you
okay.
Lightweight actually, it's very lightweight, and you can use this one.
Is it only for Mac OS or
no, Windows also? It's automatically it's detecting the this one actually. Mac and Ubuntu also is there.
Okay.
Even Visual Code also is there. Who are familiar with Visual Studio or Visual Code, right? They can use the Visual Code also. Visual Code also is a open source actually. You can use that also.
IntelliJ is also there,
Yes, that is heavy. If you are full stack developer, that's fine actually. You can do because it will be used for your Java project also and other Android projects also, right? That will be. If you are only working on the UI part, these are the lightweight editors actually. You can use.
Okay.
And then let me show you how to run this project actually.
Only one doubt.
Yeah.
In the package or JSON, when you mention about the dev dependencies, right?
So UI framework, the version you have mentioned. So the version is like whenever you are creating React app, that time you tell the version, or
whenever we are creating the CRA boilerplate, right? That time only we will mention the packet.json. There we will mention the version actually.
Okay.
Lerna, we will means anyhow we have to register in lerna.json also. There is a package we have to register here actually. Lerna okay. will take care of building that thing actually. That okay. will take, and wherever that in dependency will be there, that will keep on adding it as a node models.
Oh, thank you.
It's just a main. Yeah.
Hello.
Yes. Yeah.
Murli, one thing. Suppose we are going to create a new CRA project. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So in that time, we have our package.json, which will tell all the dependencies on that.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. now it is my new CRA project that I am developing for some new module for this one. In that mm-hmm. case, in this mm-hmm. package.json, which one are the dependencies mm-hmm. that I need to mention? Like, see. The common thing that you told, that is like ego UI kit and ego UI framework and all these two, mm-hmm. that is required yeah. for my new module also. And all the other things mm-hmm. like suppose PGR citizen and all the other like TL related things are also there. Do I need to mention mm-hmm. all these things? Which are the things that is my dependency that only I need to provide in package.json, right?
Yes, correct. That's true. Yeah. Yeah, okay. even we have created the boilerplate for new models actually. For example, if you are going to create a new project, okay. Mm-hmm. For example, the master level, product level,
okay.
we have created one boilerplate in the dev packages. You can go to this boilerplate, okay. You just copy this boilerplate and you can rename it. And we can start developing the new model actually. This is the boilerplate for new models. Ego boilerplate dev actually.
Okay, dev package.
Here we have mentioned all the dependencies needed for new models actually. New models.
Okay.
Whatever new models we are creating, all the dependencies are ready actually. You just rename the names and we have to use it actually. That's all.
Okay.
Even that also we have created a brief document which step by step how to create a new project and how to use it actually. Okay. That also I will tell Jelzen to share all the documents. Everyone can go through that.
Okay.
Okay, let me show you how to run these projects actually. Anyhow, we have to go to that location actually, where the Rainmaker folder is there. Okay, there we have to go there, and then we have to first run the command that will take care of interconnecting all the models actually. For example, if we see our projects, right? For example, citizen packet.json. Okay, these are the dependencies are there actually. If we are freshly cloning the repository, means there is no node modules folder will be there. Correct, right? There is no node modules folders will be there. We have to. This is the packet.json will tell about the development means environment. These are the dependencies we are needed for running this project. Correct. Right? For that, downloading that dependencies, third-party dependencies, and interconnecting our custom modules, we have created one command actually. That is go actually. Okay. This command we have to run first. And it will download all the third-party libraries like React.js and Redux. Those are the third-party libraries. And some of the common custom one that will be there in our project only, that will take care of, Lerna will take care of interconnecting those models actually. And I'm using Yarn actually. Means this is a just computator of NPM. Okay, who are familiar with the npm, they can go with the npm only. Arn is another competitor. Again, okay, that I'm using. What we have to do is we have to go to the Rainmaker folder level and we have to do Arn Go actually. This will take care of interconnecting and downloading and transferring all the models actually. Currently I'm following this document only. This is the document I have created. Here I have step by step I have mentioned how to run this project. We need as a new system, for example, it's a first time you go, means we need to install Lerna in the global level. Then we have to run the run go and it will take care of interconnecting all the models actually. First time only we have to run this command actually. This will take 10 to 15 minutes first time because it has to download all the third party, because around we are having 15 to 10 models, 10 to 15 models, right? That dependencies and analysis has to download. That's why it will take some time. And after this completion,
I'm really carry on.
Yes, you can ask it, sir.
Yeah, actually I have one doubt. See, you said citizen and employee are two main applications, right? So now both are CRA applications. So now when we create the application, basically it has its individual known modules. So the one, the common ones which are there between both the services, are they maintained at a common place and it can be fetched from that point, or copies of each is maintained in each individual node module? Hope you got my question right.
Okay, I lost last sentence actually.
Yeah, suppose when we are creating the CRA for citizen and employee, right, node modules will get created. So the common ones which are there in both the services, are they there in those services, or they are kept at a common place so that to avoid redundancy basically?
Yeah. Okay.
Are they maintained? Okay. You got my question, right?
Yes, yes.
Should I explain?
Yes. Yeah. For example, I will take actually trade license is a one model. It's having the citizen view also and employee view also. Correct, right? That time what will happen is, okay, we will have the route level dependency actually. For example, citizen wise we will have different route, and employee it will have different route actually. And also each component is authorized actually. For example, employee have the access to that component, means then only we will show that component actually. Okay, like that we have architected. And once I go to the single model, right? Once I take the single model, we will get some clear idea. But it's in the organized way actually. There is no dependency you won't see actually. You won't see any redundancy actually. Won't see there is no dependency redundancy. That also I will show you.
The modules which are common, like. There is one module that is present in citizen, and the same module, there is a same dependency in the employee module also. The dependency during the time of dependency resolution, only one copy of that particular dependency is referred, right? Or multiple times the
one copy. Okay. For example, here we have created the trade license, right? A trade license, once I run the and run go actually, this is completed actually. Once it ran, right, what will happen is currently all the CRA project project are there in the ES6 code actually. This is the ES6, ECMAScript 6 version actually. You can see all the spread operator and arrow function, and there is a string templating. Those type of coding you can see here actually. But when it goes to the NPM level, right? NPM level, we should be placed as a ES5 project actually, okay? The NPM level, it should be ES5 project, okay? That's why what we are doing is, when we are running the and run go, we are transferring ES6 to ES5 and placing that copy inside the packet.json. There is a folder, is the lib actually. Here we are placing all the models actually. One copy we are placing here. This copy we are referring inside employee and citizen application. The difference is that one only actually. These are the models, dev packages, whatever we have written, right? That is in the ES6 and ES7 portion. And whatever there in the this level, this is in the ES5 actually. You can see ES5 require, you can see ES5. These are the ES5 code. Okay, this code we won't generate. The whatever the command I ran, right, that will take care of generating these folders, and these folders will be referred to both citizen and employee application. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay. That we understood, right? ES6 and ES5, that we understood, right?
Yeah. Up to certain extent, it's understood.
Okay.
Murali, one question. Why is this ES6 converted to ES5?
This is for currently in the citizen and employee application. What will happen is the custom function or custom modules, whatever we created, right, that will come and sit inside the node modules actually. Node modules. Okay, here if I go to the it will come inside the node modules. Node modules, whatever code is there, right? The compiler, whatever compiler we are using in the React script, there is a package is there actually that will take care of transferring ES6 to ES5. That whatever there in this folder, that should be there in the ES5 version actually. Then only the compiler will understand actually. Hello?
Okay.
Okay, that is the thing. Even we can see some of the ES6, ES7 code is there, right? If I open the something like console, and if I write that command, right, it won't work, correct, right? It will tell us some invalid, means undefined, or some errors will come, right? That's why browser won't understand all the ES6 and ES7 code actually. Okay, that's why we have to convert that into ES5. Then only the browser will understand. Even we have seen some command, right? That is the and build actually, and build. Okay, if you do the and build, what will happen is it will create a build folder inside our CRA project, right? CRA project, there is a build folder will generate all the converted uglified JavaScript JavaScript code will be there. Okay, this will be understandable by browser actually. Okay, direct ES6 code is there, right? The browser won't understand the direct ES6 and ES7 code actually. That's why we have to convert into ES5.
Okay, so this is at the compiler will do. We need not have to do anything for
Yes.
Thank you.
Whatever script we have created, that will take care of converting this one actually. Okay. Currently, the project is, we have successfully ran the and go command, and all the projects are interconnected. Yeah. And you can see all the modules will have node modules actually. Once you freshly download the project, that time there you won't see the node models folders for each models actually. You won't see node models folder actually. If you go to the individual level, you won't see. After running the AnGo, it will create a node models in each module, okay? And it will put the dependencies there actually. It will have dependencies there. And if I go to the E level, you can see ego. Okay, you can see here ego UI framework. This is our custom package we have created, ego workflow. Okay, these are the custom packages we have created. That also it will take care of inject here actually. Okay. Next is I just successfully transferred and interconnected each model. Now, if I want to run the citizen and employee application, means what we have to do is we have created some commands for that. Okay, if I want to run the citizen in dev mode, okay, here is a command actually. We have to run with an and run space that command or just an that command. Now it will start the citizen in dev mode, and here we'll start the employee in dev mode. Actually, here you can see employee also there is a command is there. I'm running both the application. We close the. This is the UIT version I have opened that time. I just close that applications, and I will close the reference part. It won't be confused for. Let it be GitHub like that only. npm. It's a starting application. Both applications are starting. Already 3000 is used in for citizen, right? That's why it's asking it's already used. You just do the enter. It will take 3001 for running employee application.
Only when I add a new package, okay, I will be adding in dev package and the citizen and employee. In that part also, do I have to add some mapping that okay, add this package into citizen, or will actually that mapping has to be done?
Yes, that also I will show you.
Okay.
As I told you in this document.
Okay, so you will be covering. Okay.
Here, adding in. Yeah, here adding the new model I have explained here. What I have to do is the application will take some time. Till that time, I just give you some idea actually. It will be, you will get some idea actually. So for example, I told you there is a boilerplate we have given actually. You have to copy that boilerplate actually, and you have to rename whatever I mentioned here. You have to rename it to WMS, Water Management System actually. Okay, we are renaming to Water Management. Okay, whatever. It's needed actually. For example, there is a whatever green states will come, right? They will ask for the waste management, correct? Right? Waste management they will ask. Okay, that time waste management, ego waste management. Okay, that model we will create. And whatever I mentioned, just we have to rename actually. We have to rename. We are renaming all the packet.json, and after that, we are changing some route actually, whatever, wherever boilerplate existence is there, that we are renaming. And after that, miss some renaming still will be there. Then, if I go down, right, we have to create some script command that is related to that model actually, new model. Okay, that also I have mentioned. Then we have to go to the employee module and we have to register that new module actually. Ego, WN, water and sewerage, and this is the version we have to mention in employee and citizen. Then we have to change something. This one, going forward, I will explain.
Okay.
And even we have to tell learner to, there is a new model actually. Here also we have to register. The learner, we have to register, there is a new model. Then if you run the and run go, after adding the new model, we have to run the npm run go or and run go, and then you can run the employer citizen. Actually, running this ego application, we need at least 8 GB RAM. Actually, 4 GB might be system might be very slow. Okay, that you have to see. I mean, you are working on the this front end part. It depends actually how many modules you are running for the state. That depends actually. If you are running all the 15-16 modules, system load also will be more. That time it will take some time. If you are running only some modules to state, means some miscellaneous collection and some trade license, that time it won't take much time. But that might be a criteria. Means you can check that thing also. This is for developer actually, who are developing and adding new features. They should have that configuration.
Only previously we were able to run the code and npm run go, we were able to do it. Today when I'm trying again checkout and doing the thing, so it's giving me one error that rainmaker citizens at the rate 0.0.2 start js react script start, it's failing at that level. Means
okay, well, better I will share all the after this call only. I will tell Elzen to share this this one so that we can mention the related issues in the comment section. I will see that comments actually. I will keep on seeing these comments and who are facing the problem.
I can do one thing. I will share you on Confluence page. You can hook up all these links to where I'm telling, because they have access to that particular Confluence page.
Okay. Sure. Both applications are running now. Okay, you can see this is the employee login page and this is the citizen login page. Okay. You can log in. First time, if you are first time, you have to register. So I will take some employees. Okay. We take employee 9 only. And it is testing. Okay. We have to select, then login, and this will be employee dashboard. the difference is employee is driven by role action mapping. Actually, whatever action we have given to that employee, that part only he can able to see actually. Okay. For example, this employee name, he is having the access to complaints, property tax, and M collect actually. Okay. If we see the citizen view, right, here we have four models, but those models not coming for the this EMP9. Because fire renewal is missing your trade license. It's because of the role action mapping actually. We have given the limited role action mapping to that particular employee. That's why he is able to see only those models actually. Okay, this is the difference. This is about running the application in your local. Okay, then we can move to some changes and we can see how you go your framework. It will work. That we can see in the next
chapter. Murli.
Yeah.
Murli. Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Suppose no. Currently I am working on one module at a time. Like we will be working on one module. So instead of importing all these dev packages, if I remove the whatever not dependent on my package, for example, I am working on PT employee dev. So, how can I keep only this this module, and I can make the application less heavy?
Yeah, yeah. What we can do is, for example, we have to we can take as this new state actually. New state. Just I'm giving the example. New state. There might be a module launching PJF complaints module. And the universal collection, miscellaneous collection. What we have to do is in the learner, we have to remove those models actually. We have to remove those models. And then we have to come to the employee and citizen application. Here we have to remove those models actually. Whatever we don't, we have to remove.
Okay, one is in learner. I need to include the module that the only one I am working on.
Yes, yes, yeah.
Correct. And the second one is in the particular folder, means which project I am working on that package.json, I have to, what I need to do?
Here you have to remove, for example, HRMS you are not launching and trade license you are launching. You are not launching and even fire NOC also we are not launching. That time what we have to do is we have to remove that models from the packet.
Okay, so
from that time, yeah.
Tell me.
Yes, that time it will be lightweight actually. This build will contain only the universal collection and PGR models actually.
Okay. So two things are package.json and the learner, right?
Yeah. And even we have the easy way to run these projects actually. For example, you are working on the universal collection. The developer is working on the universal collection, right? That time, what the developer can do is he can run only the universal collection. Anyhow, this is a CRA project. Okay. After and go, he can come to this module. He can do and start actually. He can do and start. It will run independently. This module will run independently.
Okay. So instead of doing all these things, I can navigate to my corresponding module only and can run over there, correct?
Yes. Yeah. Even that also I will show how we can run. That also I will show.
Okay.
At this method, it will bypass all the login, this thing, right? Login process, if we run the specific module.
Specific module also. This approach we have taken recently actually. Few models we have given the login page also actually. If you are running individually, we are given the login page also. Once you run the universal collection independently, you will get the miscellaneous collection. This is a miscellaneous collection. You will get the login page. You have to log in and you have to go further actually. And another approach is you have to run the application in 3000 port. For example, you want to run the citizen part of the this trade license. What you have to do is you have to run in 3000, you just log, no need to log out, just close the execution. Just you have to close this execution. Same port you have to run that application. That time, whatever the local storage and authentication, whatever it will be stored in the local storage, right? It will regain to that particular application. That is another way we can step by step we can. Any idea which application we are going to deploy first, actually, so that I can go to that application, I will do some changes and I will show you how we can do the okay. This is about the running the application. This is the way we can run the application in integration way, actually. For example, we have integrated the universal collection way, mCollect in employee and citizen, and we are running now, actually. You can see here, the mCollect application is here. And here we can search the tags 6368700, and we can search your whatever mCollect receipts are there. You can search here and you can download, and you can even create a new application, new mCollect application, and you can fill everything and you can go for it. Okay, I will just go through the mCollect once. Actually, you will have, who are, don't know the mCollect, they will get some idea. Okay.
One more thing, if you will be able to explain as a workflow wise, means code wise workflow, so if you can provide that, means as such, we know that how the Redux work, but in your product wise, how the things are, you are managing it, like how the states in which particular package you are, because you are using this like middleware and all that, and it's again part of the common framework or it's an individual one, so. One flow, if you can explain us, it will be easy for us to map it.
A code wise also I will go, actually. I just give the mSeva, miss about mSeva, just some small idea, then I will go to the my framework, actually, whatever framework we have created, and then I will change some field, actually, add the field, some new field, and change some fields, actually. Then we can go through the application. Anyhow, it's still 4:30, right? I can cover something. If I miss, means we can miss. I will give. I will extend the session also. Whatever, whatever missing things we have given.
Thank you.
Okay, because the UI part is very big. Actually, it's a three and a half year application. It's very big. Actually, 2.5 hour. I can't complete briefly. We definitely will extend the sessions. If we need, actually, we will definitely extend the session.
Okay.
mCollect is one application. There we can collect the fees. Something like if you want to collect from the government, if you want to collect parking, actually, okay, you can use this application and you can collect the money, actually, parking fees for 2-wheeler, 3-wheeler, whatever is there. For example, I'm giving, actually. Okay. Once we, as I told you, this will have the search option. Here you can search the previous mCollect receipts, actually. Okay. And also you can create as a counter employee or as a field inspector. Okay. Field collector, you can collect the amount from the field, actually. Okay. Here we have to mention our mobile number, the customer mobile number, and the name. And you have to select the category. Tax is a category, and NOC. Something like NOC I will select. Okay. You have to select the date range. Tax is 200 rupees. Rest I will just rest. These are the other tags actually. Okay, I'm just leaving like this only. Okay. Clicking on this one, what will happen is it will show the estimation, how much amount you have to pay, the customer has to pay, and this is the counter employer, right? Counter employer are field inspector or field collector who are going to the field, right? Those will have this view actually. Okay. He can collect that guy is paying from cash, a check, a DD, and credit card actually. Okay, this we can select paid by owner. This one. The G8 section is sometime what will happen. Assume like when we went to the field, right? That time there is no internet. Okay, and might be some users manually collecting the information and coming to the office and entering the data. Okay, that time what we are doing is we might be having hard copy of the check receipt book actually. Might be we are writing there amount 200 rupees and there might be some receipt number will be there. Okay, that we are giving to the customer, right? That time we are using the G8 this card actually. Okay, when we come back to the office, that time we will refer that receipt number actually. Something like there 110 is there, that number we will enter here. Okay.
Can this you show other tabs also? Like check,
okay.
DD, credit, just to see the UI, what
yeah.
It is now.
Yeah, check, DD.
No, other options credit. Are there, no? Check, DD, and credit, debit. Just wanted to see the UI, what is there, what information we need to capture.
Yeah, that only I'm showing, yeah. Credit card, okay. This is credit card, DD, and check, and cash.
Okay, fine.
Okay. Assuming like that guy is collecting by cash actually, the user is giving by cash. But then we are selecting cash and entering the data and click on generate receipt. And it will show your receipt number and you will get a notification message also to the mobile, this much amount you paid for this category. And then you can view the received. Here two copy will be there, one for the citizen and one for the employee. You can see here. And then you can go for next collection or go back to the home. Okay. This is for the M collect actually. It's this is not about the you can tell as a super collect of the collection of the models actually, multiple model correct, right? Randomly if you want to collect for collect money for some new feature, new models or something, you can add it into the M collect and you can collect that amount actually from the citizen.
Okay,
yeah,
okay, actually for all this data part in the sense, say receipt number, then service mm-hmm. category. The mm-hmm. service category that we are actually reading from the MDMS data.
Yes, yes, yeah.
Can you just show in our VS Code or Atom, like how we are fetching this data from MDMS and populating into my domain?
Yeah, yeah. That also I will cover actually. That also I will cover.
Oh, okay.
And are we targeting for the POS machine also, M collect, or it's just a counter collect actually? Do you have any idea for that thing?
Right now we are not sure. Maybe it may be there. I need to confirm. So do you have the integration with the POS?
Yes, yes. We have the POS machine. We recently done the integration for POS machine also. That also we are having the document actually, which how to collect the, which we have written the architecture also, and how to collect money from the POS machine actually. There we will have the option to, the machine will have the this card option actually, swiping and tapping and everything will be there. That also we have integrated for Punjab. Punjab, it's in still in the UIT level. Soon we'll go to the field.
This, okay, in case of check and DD, you are entering that information over there in that UI, right? While collection. Deposit has already happened to their account, like or and just you're entering the information, or you will just collect the check or DD and you will enter, and it's your responsibility to deposit in that bank account.
That is again a business case, actually, how they are planning to handle that. They can configure, might be some state, some ULB, they won't provide the DD option. That time, if you are going to pay by DD, the API will throw the error. Actually, there is a business service MDMS configuration is there. There we are configuring this ULB will have cash and card, actually.
Suppose, say for example, they have selected the check option, then you are entering the check details over there, right, in that another tab. You are entering the check number and all those things. So like, it means like you are like counter employees collecting the check from that citizen and entering that information, or like already it has been deposited, that check is already being deposited to account, and then here just we are entering the details for like receipt purpose.
Just entering, actually, there is no validation, only the IFSC code we are validating. For example, if you are doing for the that's still have to go back. Actually, IFSC is, there is an integration, actually. Apart from other, we don't have any integration. For example, I understood whatever check number, deed number they are adding, right? You are saying, are we validating with the bank API and showing some error message or not? Just that only you are asking, right? That we are not doing currently. It's just entry, manual entry. What will happen is, might be some model will have something like for example, if the DDR of check is bounced, right, that time what will happen is, we will cancel the receipt, and whatever we have given the receipt for that user, that will be cancelled automatically. Actually, there is other workflow will be there for that part. This is about the end collect. Okay, as I told you, we have the POS machine integration also. Okay, it depends upon which vendor we are going, that they might be giving their bank integration details, actually, that we have to integrate. And even the printing part, everything we have done here, actually. This part machine will internally will have the printing options and all that, and all we have. And we have done the documentation. This and all I will share after this call. Okay. Now going back to the UI part. Okay. We just seen the application level, actually, what is mCollect and everything. Okay. Now we'll go back to the our framework, actually. Before understanding the framework, if I go to the code level, we won't get anything, actually. Means it's just I'm saying that's all. Just I will go to the Ego framework, actually, Ego UI framework. Okay. Ego UI framework is a one framework we have developed, actually. Okay, we have the Ego, we have developed. Using this framework, means creating many screens, actually. Using this framework, we are creating many screens. Okay, I will give the simple idea of how the framework will work, actually. Okay, in the means currently, if I want to create a new screen, means we just create a configuration, actually. For example, this is a configuration, screen configuration. Here we have written some configuration. Okay, and this configuration will read by our framework, and it will display the particular screen, actually. Okay. Currently, we have developed all the components needed for new model, actually. We have around 40 to 50 components ready in our framework, actually. Okay. That's why no need to create any new components. Just creating like this configuration, and it will take care of rendering the screen, actually. this framework part I will take you later, because this framework we can't finish it in this time stamp only, because it will take more time actually. I just giving the example how we are creating the screen in e-governance actually. Here you can see here React where to write a component. Okay, here we have mentioned our framework to write a component. This way we will write a component in our framework. Okay, this is the custom framework we have developed. Here we will just write a JSON type of configuration. That will our framework will read this configuration. It will render the screen actually. I just giving high level idea. It's not a deep one actually. Any questions here?
Yeah, means if you are okay, we can extend a bit. Means for you if you are available, because for us the UI also.
Sure. We can. Yeah. Because this UI framework only it's around 2 hours KT actually, because you are knows the React, right? I have to go through the framework and I have to show all the components and how the data will flow in the framework level. That I have to explain. That will take more time. That's why just I'm giving some idea how we are creating the screen actually. That's all.
Okay.
But this session I will take actually. I will ask Eljan to schedule one more session, okay, for explaining this UI framework.
Thank you.
Just currently we can understand, we will write a configuration to render the create a screen. That is our understanding actually. Yeah. Now I will go back to the code level. Okay, this is the framework we are using. Even GitHub level also I have explained. Okay, here just I'm showing this one. Means how to add a new screen configuration in new model actually. We will go to this level actually. We will go to the configuration screen and specs level, and we will create one file. Okay, we will create one folder first, then we will create a file, and then what we are doing is just writing the configuration actually. Right, writing the configuration like this. Okay, it will take care of rendering the screen. Okay, I just give you one small screen idea how we are creating the screen, then I will go a little deep actually. Currently UC is a model. Okay, if you want to create a new screen, what we have to do is we have to go to the UI config, screens specs, and UC is a folder. Okay, what you have to do is here you have to write new file. New file is test.js. This is the screen I'm going to create. Test.js is a, now it will become a screen actually. Okay. Next, what we have to do is, as per the configuration, I just tell you. Next, we have to create a const screen config, one constant actually. Okay. Constant you have to create, and we have to mention the framework. Just I will take the small part actually instead of good. beautify, let me beautify the code. Beautiful. Okay. As who are the React developer, right? Their way to create a screen is just importing the first. We have to create a route, correct? Right? We have to create a route. Then we have to assign one component to that route, correct? Right? Then we have to write a React way to write some create a component, import React and Redux, whatever is needed, and then we have to write a render part and everything, right? In the Ego, we have created one custom framework actually. Okay, that what it will do is just read that custom configuration and it will render the screen actually. Okay, just now I have created one custom screen configuration. Okay, this is a screen configuration. It's telling there is a screen that is having one field actually. Okay, one field. That field name is field is test field with icon, and these are the pops to that component actually. Okay, label is email, and you can see there is a one icon we have added. Okay, this I will come back later actually. Okay, just I'm giving the idea how we are creating the screen. Okay, after adding the new screen, what we have to do is we have to run the model related command actually. Yeah. Model related. Assume like you have changed some UC related code. Okay. What we have to do is packet.json. I have created UC related one script actually. Okay. Because why you have to run is this code is referring this code we have transferred and we have put here, right? UC is here actually. Okay, UC is here. If I go to this level, there is no test.js, correct? Right? This is the common project, this module we are referring inside citizen and employer. There is no test.js. Okay, and that test.js should be in the ES5 standard, correct? Right? That is not there. Generating that file, okay, we have created one command related to that module actually. And Ego, you see, you have to run. After running this command, you can see citizen and employee application is compiling again. Okay. Compiling again, there is a one new file came, test.js. Okay. This is in ES5. It will take some seconds to re-render because this is the integration part, right? You have changed in the UC module level, that should be re-rendered in the employee and citizen, correct? Right? That's why it will take some time. Currently, I have added new screen actually using Ego UI framework. You are getting some idea, just transferring, just I'm asking, are you getting some idea? I mean, I will definitely go deep on this configuration and everything. But are we getting some idea seeing this configuration, what we are going to achieve?
Right, you are using the Material UI UI framework, extending that and adding a new component with some name, mm-hmm. with the properties, mm-hmm. right?
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
And using the JSON path, it will get mapped to that particular request, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes. Here, React way, we won't write a screen actually. It's a Ego way, we will write a screen actually. That is the difference actually. Because this text component is already created by Ego members. Okay. Here, if I go to the Ego UI framework, okay. Here, we have created the text with icon component is already written actually. Okay, already written. Okay, we just write a configuration for render that component actually. Okay, are we getting some idea?
Yeah,
so actually, all the major components that are used are already written, and we are just
making just use of the components. Yes, composition. Just we are doing the composing actually. Just taking that component and using in your screen, and it, the screen is done. That's all. We currently you no need to write any components. Okay, that is needed for your module actually.
Muli, line number 2 is there, na? UI framework, material UI. So again, it can have the different values, or it's always going to be material UI only.
This is a fallback actually. For example, if you are not mentioning this one in the each field level, component level, if you are not mentioning this one, right? Okay, it will pick this component from the material UI. That is the.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the screen name. This is the screen name, and this is the components come inside that screen actually. Currently, I put only one component, okay? Only one component, that's why it's having only one component actually. Login username is one component I put, and that definition here actually. What is the framework? Custom molecule, this is a custom molecule. I just tell you actually, here in the ego, we won't say component as is component actually, okay? We will say component, we are dividing component into three part actually, okay? Atoms, molecules, and containers actually, okay? It's a physics word actually. Atom means button is an atom actually. What? Okay, text field is an atom, okay? Molecules means collection of atom is a molecule actually, okay? That is the new name we are following here actually, okay? Just for the differentiation.
Okay.
So that is a text field with icon, that's why it's a molecule, is it?
Correct. You are correct. Okay. It's a collection of two atoms, that's why it's a molecule. See, now I have created new screen, correct, right? New screen. This is the test.js is a new screen, okay? How to open this screen? Currently, I am running the UC model, correct, right? What you have to do is UC/search. What will happen is it will point to currently UC model. UC is folder, okay? UC is a folder. The same thing, UC is a folder, okay, and search is a screen, okay, that's why our framework is reading this file and rendering the screen actually, okay. Currently I have added new file test.js, okay. Reading that file, what you have to do is UC/test, you have to write actually, UC/test. You can see here, right? UC.text I have entered. That's why our framework read this file. Okay, it's read whatever we have written the configuration. I'm saying only one component should be screen. Test screen should contain one component. And that's why we are seeing this one component. Okay, that component name is text field with icon. Okay, what is the type of the component is? Type of the component is, it's a molecule actually, custom molecule. Okay. What is the props? These are the props actually. This is the pattern. If I enter something else, it will fail. Okay. If it is required, you have to mention required. This JSON path means if I enter the data, where it should be stored actually. Okay, that part.
So you always use the browser path to go to that particular page rather than okay.
Yes. Because this is a framework actually. We have created a custom framework. That's why whoever the developer is there. No need to create any route actually. No need to create any route. If you are going to create a new service, no need to create any routes actually. Just create a file. Okay. And use our framework and write a configuration like this. And then transfile your code, transfile your module, whatever module related script you have to run. Okay. That time that script will regenerate the code for that module, and that will be updated in citizen and employee application.
So actually, does it reload when we say the slash UC slash test?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, does it reload the page, complete page, or means what?
Currently, there is no menu action for the test. That's why I have to forcefully reload the page actually.
Okay.
You are getting it, right?
Yeah. Okay.
In real scenario, you will have some menu action, something like that name, and clicking on that one, that screen will come actually. It's a single page application, spa application. Okay. Okay.
Murli, I have a doubt. How will you write an action for a button if you have to write the components like that? Now, if you have a login button, action. So, what now in login? What action we have to do? How do we specify that in the code for that component?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Action means button wise. You are
button wise. Now, if I put a login button in that component.
Yeah. Okay.
Like, how do we attach events to the buttons?
We have the document. There we have mentioned. I have mentioned all the atoms and molecules actually. Even related code also I have mentioned. Let me go take the one example. Phone number. If you want to display the phone number, means you have to copy this configuration actually. Okay. You have to copy this configuration and rename whatever name you want to rename. Okay. That part will render here actually. Okay. And if you want to display the app bar, you have to refer this code configuration button. Okay. Let me take button. Okay. Action. Login button. Okay. This is the login button is the ID to that component actually. Okay. This should be unique. Whatever component you are creating, that should be unique actually. Okay, login button. Then what I will do is I will copy paste the configuration I have taken from the document. Okay. What I will do is I will take the simple button component. Simple button means the button. This button. Is the variant is I want to use the variant outlined actually, outline button. And there is a this is the first question is how to add a button actually. Okay, button and props I am sending outlined actually. Okay. And then button will have the definition, unclick definition. Yeah, unclick definition. Okay. Here, what you can do is you can mention what action you want to do actually. It's a page submit, or you are going to change the route. Okay. So that thing you can mention. There is a three type of action we are providing actually. Okay. One is submit. Submit is one action, and page change is another action. Okay, and condition. Okay, condition is another action. Three types means what will happen is, okay, the button click will happen for in the our ego purpose. We have assumed button will click for three types actually. Okay, one might be if you want to submit the form. Okay, you want to submit the form. Another thing is you want to go to the next route actually. Clicking on this button, you want to go to the property tax. Okay, this is the change of the route actually. Okay, change of the React route. Okay, and next one is clicking on that button, you want to call some API. Okay, you want to call some API. Okay, then you will pass whatever data you have entered. Okay, and that will go to that API, that API will validate and it will give the response. Okay. That type of condition is there, right? Condition is you have to mention the onclick definition actually. Okay, onclick definition, and there is a callback function will be there that will have we will pass you state dispatch, we'll pass, and you have to do anyhow. If you get the state of whole application, it's just pass whatever you want to take from the state and pass the values from the state, and then call the API. Okay, this will be the button definition. Button definition. Okay, this will be the button definition. Okay, three type I have mentioned actually. Submit and change. Page change. If the page change is there, means this will change actually. The page change is means you have to tell which path you want to go actually. You have to mention clicking on that button. I want to go to the property tax model. You have to mention like this. Is it clear actually? Means I will take care of explaining the whole framework to who are interested then in the next extended session actually. Just for the high level idea, you can just take this actually.
Okay. High level idea. Thank you. Thank you, sir. It's clear.
Okay, this way we will create a screen. This is about how to create a screen, I have told you, right? You want take any break, you can take a break and you can have 30 minutes or 40 minutes session after that. If you want, you can take actually.
Yeah, Mori, you also take a break.
Okay. Can we connect at 4 o'clock?
Yeah. So Muli, what after this, what you will be explaining?
I will explain whatever screen is there. I will just take the login screen actually. Simple screen. Okay, simple screen. There is a MCS, there is a login screen is there actually.
Okay.
So this simple login screen I will take. I will explain how the APIs are calling, where we are calling the APIs. Okay.
Okay.
And
okay.
Clicking on this one, the API will call. It will validate the field actually. That okay. part I will explain, and I will add some more field here actually. And I will show you how to edit the screen that is already developed by us actually.
Okay.
Actually, these are the things you are knowing without understanding the whole framework actually. Once I give the proper KT and the framework, right, that time you will understand better actually. Whatever I explained now, it will be better in that situation.
Can you repeat it? Means what you are saying?
Means when I taken the complete Ego UI framework KT, right? That time right. you will get a better idea actually. Better idea.
Oh,
whatever will explain, that will be something like high level idea glance you are getting actually.
Right.
But you won't be getting the exact point I am saying. Might be okay. That time might be this that those confusion and doubts will be clear.
Right. Okay. Now also actually it's quite clear. Yeah.
That's why I'm going slow actually. Let it take some time now. But main thing is you guys has to understand the things actually. That is the main.
Right. Okay.
Okay, we'll connect 4-5 or something.
Sure.
Okay, thank you. Hello. Hello.
Yeah, Mundi.
Yeah, everyone back, right?
Just one minute.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. 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 Let me resume that session. I will take this example, login example, and I will show you what will happen.
Muli, can you come close to the microphone in between the voice and not coming actually?
Okay, okay. What about now?
Yeah, it's good.
I will take the MCS example only. Okay, maybe you will get some idea, because anyhow you are taking this model to the new state actually. Okay.
Only your screen is not shared.
Okay. Sorry. Okay, what about now?
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay. I'm developing this application, debugging this application. Okay. And I will show you how the flow will be there. Okay. I will start from the flow from this folder only actually. Means how we will hit this route and how that this page is imported dynamically, that part I will explain in the framework, explaining the framework actually. Okay, now I just go directly to this page level and I will show you how the API calls will happen and how the actions were happening, that I will show. Okay, yeah, let me go to get data. Okay, this is the extended configuration actually. Normal configuration as we've seen, right? That is very simple actually. This is a simple screen, correct, right? Very simple basic screen configuration we have seen. Okay, for extended one means we have some hooks actually. For example, before loading this screen, if I want to call some API, if I want to do some other calculation, okay, you can do with this before init screen hook actually. This is a hook we have created. Okay, here you can do your custom things actually before loading the screen. Okay, and let me refresh my page. Okay, and you know, here you see search has mentioned, that's why it will hit to that search screen. Okay, it hits to the search screen. As I told you, before loading the screen, you are seeing here the screen has not loaded still now. Okay, it hits to this part. Okay, here we will get the state. Okay, what is the current state? And dispatch is used to dispatch the action. Okay, and the current screen configuration actually. The three part we will get. Let me go back to the definition of get data. Put a breakpoint, it will be easy to understand. Now I'm moving the breakpoint to next one. Now it came to the get data. Get data is asynchronous calls because here we are calling the API actually. Then clicking on the get MDMS data, there we are passing again the same parameter, whatever came from the get data. Then it will go to the get MDMS data. Here we are constructing the request body for the API actually. Yeah, request body of the API. You can see here, this is the MDMS call, right? MDMS call and we have to construct the request as per their contract actually. So here we will have the request body and it will have the modules definition, module detail definition. It's the array of object and here you have to mention which is the business service, okay, module name, which is the module name and which master you are interested actually. I'm interested in business service master. And here also you can put the filters actually, okay? Filters, which are the, filter means, for example, we might having multiple thousands of business service, okay? We are interested in the type ad hoc actually, okay? I think last multi-session whoever attended, there the same question has came actually, means how we are calling the API and how can we send the filters and those questions only has came, right? Okay, the same thing I'm explaining here. I will go to the same MDMS also. Anyhow, each state will have state-related MDMS repository, correct, right? I'm going to the Punjab, and I'm showing the demo in UAT, right? UAT, okay? Let me go to the... UAT branch. UAT is pointing to the environment. The UAT branch is pointing to the UAT environment. Okay. Here I'm going to the business service. This is MDMS configuration. I think whoever attended the MDMS session, they are clear about the MDMS, right? Why we are using the MDMS? That is, those are clear, right?
Great.
Yeah. Here you can see the each module will have a folder actually. Business service is a folder and business service folder will have the masters actually. These are the masters. Okay. In the code I am mentioning, I'm interested on business service master. Okay. And business service master. And here I'm looking for the and you can send this filter also. Type is ad hoc. You can see some examples. The type is ad hoc. Yeah. If you send that, if you send those information and mention what is the action, because we have created some util function actually. Okay. Might be in your project, we might be using axios. And some REST API, third-party APIs, maybe fetch from the JavaScript. Those are the functions we are using for calling the APIs. And here we have created the custom utils, okay, for calling the API actually. Okay, HTTP request is a custom util function. There, what it will do is it will call the API, okay, but we need to send some parameter. That means what is the method? Yeah, post is a method. And what is the endpoint? And what is the action? Search is the action. And is there any query parameter? And is there any body actually, request body? Okay. Clicking on this one, let me clear the network tab. Okay. Now let me click on. Now this is a sync and await call, right? Till the API call give the response, it that will wait actually. Okay. Now you can see there is a API call has happened. And this is the part we will you no need to send explicitly actually. It will be injected by the util function, request info. With the R token, whatever logged in user app token, it will send actually. Here you can see model information, everything has went there. And filter also, you can see the preview. Let me move the breakpoint. Search. It search is again util function, so that I have to go back to the window. Set service category. Okay. I put the breakpoint here also. Let me move the breakpoint. It came to the set service category. You see now. But we here it's delaying actually. Okay. Here you can see, right, there is a dispatch screen key. Which screen you have to update and business service data. You can see whatever the business service we have mentioned in the MDMS with the type equal to ADAC, those business services came here, correct, right? Because we have to display that in the drop down actually. Whatever I shown here, this is a local development. Okay, don't confuse. Just to show you. Why we are making the API call means here we have to load the data, correct, right? Here we have to load the data. That's why we are making the API call, correct, right? Here we are loading the data. For that only we are calling the API and we are loading the data. Now see here it's actually the MDMS data, whatever we mentioned, that is a two level data actually. Okay. Here you can see the code is advt.harding, right? That means it's a two level drop down actually. Only first level we will show in here. Okay, second level will come where we are creating the new MCS M collect receipt. Okay, that time it will come. Okay. Let me I won't go inside the loop actually. It's just removing the splitting the dot and making two least actually. Okay, I don't go inside this for loop, which is looping concept. Okay, you just while debugging, you can go deep on this one. Okay. Here you can see there is a nested service data has created. Okay, and that data is this one actually. So this is the data. This is the first level drop down loading here. Okay, loading here. Those children. Okay. After that, we are setting. We are dispatching the action. It will set into the Redux actually. Redux is our central state management. Okay, next we'll go to the next one. Here we are constructing the service category. Okay, only service category, that is this one only. This is for nested, constructing nested one actually. Yeah. This is, we are converting into the array, because this drop down will understand only array actually. This is object, right? This is the object, nested service data. This is object, correct, right? This is array for the drop down actually. Then we are putting into the proper location, yeah, that dispatch will happen and the screen will load. Screen is loading actually. Okay. Yeah, you can see all the categories are loaded here. Yeah. Let's see here. Okay. This part is clear, right? Before loading the screen, how to call the API, I mean, how we are calling the API, that you guys clear, right? Miss, any question on this one, actually?
Mudli, actually, we are coding that our request, that means post request, to MDMS data.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, yeah. After that, I think I missed that from where we are calling this set service category.
I mean
this particular function.
Okay. Here, there is the util function. Just I will just quickly go to get data. Get data will call the another function, that is the async function. Get MDMS. Yeah. Get MDMS. Come here.
Get MDMS. That will fetch the data from the MDMS.
Request body. Then we are having one function set service category. Okay. This is specially for setting this. Drop-down actually. Okay. This function we will call. This is again a util function. This function actually. Here we will pass the data came from the API.
Service.
Whatever data came from the MDMS, that we are passing to that function.
Okay.
And that will receive. And then we have to distinguish actually. There is a nested level, as you told, that is in the child and parent relationship actually, dot separated.
Okay.
This is dot separated. This is dot separated actually. This first dot, whatever is there, right, this should be displayed in the this one, the drop down actually.
Okay.
That's why that function is having that much definition. This much definition it's having because of taking only the parent code actually.
Okay. So only the parent would be displayed in the drop down.
Yes, using the Redux dispatch, we are dispatching the action, and you can install the Redux third party extension. Here you can live, you can see all the actions and state for the Redux actually. So here once I dispatch, right, you can go to the prepared final object. Here you can see all the service categories. This is for the problem.
Okay.
This is for just for the relationship. For example, next if I go to the next screen, right, there is a drop down we will select. Selecting on that tags, we will show list of tags related services.
Okay, children of tags will be. Correct. Yeah. Children of tags will be.
Yes, yes. Oh. True. Yeah. Oh. Electricity, those two things.
Okay.
That will be there in the Redux actually. Whenever, anyhow, it's a single page application, whenever you want data from the Redux, we can take from the Redux and we can show it wherever we need.
Okay.
This is clear, right?
Yeah.
Now I will go to the button action actually. For example, clicking on the search or clicking on this one, what will happen actually? That action, that I will take care. If you have any question, you can ask still. I will clear that.
Only my question is like, it's not pure dynamic. It's we are designing the UI component, and in the master database, we have defined the for this drop down what should come. That is defined in master MDMS DB. Okay,
yeah.
In JSON file. It's not fully dynamic. It's like some part is static, some part is because I yesterday we were checking the report. I mean PDF generation part, right? In that completely it was dynamic.
Mm-hmm.
So
completely
report part. report part that metadata also comes dynamically, and based on that search result also come with dynamic, means the form design. But here for each and everything we are designing, but the binding is we are getting either from JSON file or database values, and that we are fetching it dynamic.
Design wise you need to write a configuration actually. Here there is a two part. One is view logic actually, and one is business logic actually. Okay, the view means whatever we are seeing here, right? That logic we need to write. Okay. After getting the API, what has to work actually? That is written by developer only, because business to business that parsing will change actually. Might be some MDMS will be a nested part. Some way might be straightforward actually. Okay, that flexibility we haven't kept in the framework level, because the PDF service is only for generating the receipt, right?
That time we can assume
what are the functionality needed for PDF service, and we can do that part in the framework level only. But here we don't know what type of business will come into our screen actually. That's why we given hooks, their user can write whatever they want to write.
Okay.
Next, anything is there for loading the part?
So it's clear.
Yeah. Okay. Then next, what you needed actually? This button click event is needed, and this search button click is needed.
Both are okay.
Into 435. You are able to extend the session for some time. That's fine, right? You all are free only, right? Or you want me to extend into next session?
We can cover it. Ragni, from your side, any dependency? I mean, anybody has to attend some other training?
No, we can continue.
Okay, we can. Yeah, we can continue. Actually, our office is till 5:30, so as such, not.
Okay. I will try to cover this both the button click actually. It's because it's a different type of button action actually. One is changing the route, one is calling the API and showing the table actually.
Okay.
That's why I will just explain those things. You will have some idea, for framework level, how the data is going on, and those information you will get some idea. That time you independently start this project and play with create a new branch and play with that branch actually. Next, I will go to the simple one, changing the route actually. Okay. There is a button, next application button. This button is there, a new application button actually. There we can see. This is the part. This belongs to that button actually, this button. Okay. Clicking on this button, there is a state will be there, and there is a dispatch will be there. There is a function we are calling open new collection form. This is the function. And what we are doing is, this is a single page application, right? First we have to there is a one demand. Demands object will be there in the Redux actually. That should be clear. Okay, then only we can open the new mCollect form actually. Okay, that's why first dispatch will happen for clearing that one. Okay, clearing that part. Then next dispatch, then we are just finding what is the route we have to go actually. Okay. Then there is a action is there, set route. Okay, that will take the path. Let me move the breakpoint. and that will open the new collection form. Just changing the new collection route actually. That means it's hitting to the new configuration inside the new collection. This stage will pass by the framework and this will start executing it. Okay. This is about the unclick to change the route actually. Change the route. Okay. Is it clear now?
So you first clear the demand, and right now there is no SS new demand, right? Means, why so we cleared that previous object, demand object?
Because here, once we create the, once the new collection flow will complete, right? There is a demand object we create actually, because here dynamically clicking on the next, we are creating the demand dynamically actually. Okay, that will be stored in the demand object. Okay, next time, this is single page application, right? We won't refresh the screen, and the Redux also will be same only. Sometime there might be a clash between the old demand and new demand. Okay, that's why the for safer side they are creating the demand.
Okay.
This is a set route is a one common action, Redux action. It will take the path, just path the pass the path actually. It will change the route. It will change the route.
Okay.
Next I'm going to search button. Okay, search button. For search button, before that I will show you, if I am selecting the tags, right? What will happen? You can see here the actions. Under features. Okay, there is the action will happen, handle screen, configuration field change. There it will take some parameter. Okay, this part I will anyhow, I'll explain, cover in the then framework level session. Okay, this is the property and this is the value. You are just sending that value. It will be stored in the Redux actually. Because once we click on the search button, those values needed for our API actually. What is the category and what is the number? Okay. Then I will go to the search form. Search card. You see search card. So that is there in this level. This is search card. You see search card. Here, if I come to that action button container, there is a button container is there. Search button. Yeah. Search API. It is there in the function. I don't go deep on this one actually. I mean, anyhow, you know the JavaScript. If you go through the debug the application, you will get a better idea actually. Anyhow, it will show the way it other times also. First, I will go with the basic one.
Okay.
Now, I'm clicking on the search button. This will click on the unclick definition of search button actually. Search button definition we have written this much. There is a unclick definition will be there. This is a conditional unclick. And here we'll get the state and dispatch. Okay. It will go to the unclick util. And let me clear the network tab. here we will call the search API. Okay, here you can see there is a search API call will happen. Okay, there we will send the information as a query string. What is the mobile number, and we have to send the all children detail. Actually, here we are not passing the actual selected value. Actually, whatever value we selected, right? For example, tax I selected. Okay, we are not sending only the tax actually. Okay, we need to send all the children. This is as per the API contract we have to send. Okay, that's why I'm saying the different model to model the API contract will change. That's why we can't restrict everything in inside the framework actually. See, here everything we are sending. The tax is having the subcategory, so no dues, electricity chunk, these and everything we will send, and the API will take the data and it will give the response. Okay. And here what we are doing, we just taking the data. Okay, data has came. Okay, these are the data, the amount is whatever the related to that thing, that category, all the data has came. Okay, then we are putting the data inside some JSON path, that means inside the Redux. Okay, then we are showing the table actually. Then we are showing the table. There is table is another component actually. Just you need to pass the data, it will take care of rendering the part. The API also called here. Any question here actually?
Why there are two dispatch calls in the code?
Where actually?
What the sender is? Yeah. Yeah, here.
In this function, right? Search.
Yeah.
Okay,
what's the significance of this?
Yeah,
to dispatch.
Oh, yeah. See, one is setting the data. Okay, this is for setting the table data, and one is for setting the this one actually 30. Okay, 30. This 30 is setting this one. This is the custom has written. That's why they are sending that dispatch also, and one is. Another one is setting the search. Okay, this is about the skill compilation actually. Anyway, this will I will cover. These two, just understanding, one is for setting the data for the table. Okay, one is for setting that this 30 number actually.
Only even we are storing means first time we are making the call, next time we are storing in the local storage, and through that we are accessing. So that part is taken care in the HTTP request, or where it actually comes?
Which one? This.
First time only you will load the data, and then you will get it from the local store, browser store. So. Means again that is a. Part of HTTP request, and that first you are checking.
That is a part of. There is a util function as I told. There is a util function has written for this one actually. That will take care of checking that local storage and taking this token actually. The token is there. This token, and putting inside the request body. and it will call the API. Actually, this is the HTTP request. Here inside we are using the Axios, actually that third party. This is a third party library used to call the API. This we have created one custom util function. This will take care of this function will take care of constructing this request body. So there we will put the action R token. R token will come from the get access token, actually. That is again a util function. There is a set of util function we have created. Okay, this will pick from the local storage.
This is the service type which you like, which is coming. So next time again, if the call happens, it will be pointing to the MDMS service only, not from the local store, right?
Yeah, MDMS. It's all the data is dynamic only. Whatever table data will be there, right? That will be dynamic only. Even if it select the same search criteria, it will call the APM.
Okay. So local store as such we are using for very limited work, right?
Yes. Redux anyhow, it's a in-memory data actually. If you refresh once the screen, the Redux will go up actually. This one will be stay till we need it actually. For example, okay. Some user related information, if the token is expressed, what is the refresh token? Okay, those information actually that will be needed for if you do the hard refresh actually.
Okay.
UI part it's not that much tight forward actually. Okay, because of flaw, it's not that much easy how the backend has developed. Okay. It's having some because of a single React application, if we do everything right, the build size will come around 100 MB actually. Loading the 100 MB in first shot, okay, it will take the time also, and it will take the user data also. Okay? That's why we have fitted everything into multiple different modules as a CRA, and then using the React loadable another plugin to do the lazy loading, and those things is there actually. Understanding it will take time actually, the project understanding, okay, and we have to go slow only for the UI understanding. Like this small, so if you take in the small application, right, module like UC is a very small module. If you understand whole UC part, that will be easy to understand trade license and fire and OC, those applications.
Okay.
Any question? If you have any questions, we can take that questions. Then we can extend. We will share the documentations also. Means if you still need the sessions, we can arrange also.
For component wise, it's better if you take the session because the learning. Yeah, product is quite good, but learning curve is a bit high.
That's true. Actually, learning is once you understand everything, you can do anything in this project. Actually, yeah.
Right.
Because microservice architecture and this part also the UI level also it's a micro project actually, micro project. Okay,
right.
That's why that also understanding it will take time. Yeah, I will take actually. I will give this document first.
Okay.
Your team can go through these documents first actually. That time in the next session you will have some high level idea. I just go deep on those points actually. Whatever the points you guys not understood, and whatever how the framework will work actually, how data will go through the framework, whatever the actions, those will I will explain in the next session.
Okay.
Any questions?
No. You have already explained that one part, like if we have to run the independent module, then we have to remove from the package JSON and run it as a separate file.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. You want to show means I will show you that part also. It won't take, it will take only five minutes actually. If you want to show, I will show that.
And you also told that we can directly go to UC project and directly execute npm run. Mm-hmm. So both are different ways, right? Or same? Like
both are same only. The difference, okay. See, here client has needed the MCS as a separate application actually. That's why in the MCS model only, we have put this login page handler. Okay, because this page is used in the POS machine actually. The same model, whatever developer referring in the employee, same model they need in the separate thing because of the performance actually. The POS machine, the people will go to the field, right? That time they should work fast. That's why we separately deployed this MCS application in new pipeline actually. The difference is it will have the login page.
Okay.
Okay, that is the difference actually. After login page, means it will like this application, whatever we are seeing here, right? If I click on mCollect, if I click on this, it's loading. Let me click. Okay, see, this part is using, right? Once I log in also, that part is same. Only the login page is the difference. Okay, yes, you are asking something actually. Yeah.
I was saying, like, for in this MCS application, you have included the login plus this mCollect.
Normal flow. Yeah. Yeah, normal flow. Whatever you are seeing here, right? That normal flow. Yeah. The difference is the left menu is not there and header is different actually.
Okay.
The thing is, when we are integrating citizen and employee, right, we just parse this configuration actually. We won't touch other part actually. For example, this CRA will have the app.js, correct? Right? App.js it will have, correct? Right? This app.js will have, here we will have the routing handler. We won't touch when we are integrating actually. We will touch only the configuration. We will take only the configuration. That's why there is no login page will come. When we are independently running, it will hit to the index.js. It will index.js will hit to the app.js. App.js will trigger the login page. That flow is different actually. Yeah, but the same project we are referring for both the thing is independently also and the.
So it's like you have defined the hook in the each and every module that whenever it's run as a separately, then login page will come. Is it something like that?
It's like it's a normal when you are running independently, it's just work as a CRA actually. When
okay.
We are working, integrating, that time we will just refer this configuration actually. We okay. Won't only this configuration folder will use actually, nothing else will use. Yeah. Because already this project structure has defined in the employee and citizen actually. If you see this project structure, is similar to that application, that product. That's why we don't need other things actually. Only configuration we need, model related configuration.
Okay. So whenever we are modifying the thing, we will be doing, whenever we are adding a new functionality, we'll be doing in UI config path only, right?
Yeah, that's all. Yeah, okay. That's all. If you just go to the, here if you want new dropdown, for example, subcategory. That time you just go to that configuration, you will just copy this configuration and you will rename and you will do it actually.
Okay. So in this Transpile citizen modules, this is also mandatory something or means to run the application?
These commands will internally used in LAN Rungo actually. First run okay. will do, right? It will install the root level dependency. And means npm I is equivalent to ARN actually. Okay. It will take care of installing root level. Then it will do the transpilation of the SCCS to CSS actually. Currently, we are using SCCS in our project. But the CRA application will not understand SCCS format actually. Okay, we have to convert that into CSS format. That's why these comments are there actually, converting SCCS to CSS. Okay, and then converting, this is for SCCS to CSS. Then we are converting ES6 to ES6 and 7 to ES5 actually. Okay, then we will do the bootstrap actually. Bootstrap is nothing but just integrating all the submodels into citizen and employee. Okay, like that we will do in the learn bootstrap.
Okay.
Because this, see, if you backtrack these commands, right, you will get this command here only. Okay, just we will get some definition. Okay. Like this, if you backtrack this one, you will get it somewhere actually. That's why there is a huge script you will see, but it will be integrated in one command actually. This the step by step for just modularizing the script set.
Okay. So when we are running a single module, Can you explain that part only? I mean, you were saying better to showcase a demo because we will be getting confused.
Mm-hmm.
Like for UC Dev, we have to run it as a separately. So mm-hmm. we are first going to remove some.
That is integration plus lightweight actually. Whatever that time I explained, right? Integration with lightweight models. Only whatever models you are needed, just we are taking that model and removing other thing. Okay.
Right.
This one is running independently that model actually. Okay. For example, you want to run the CRA application of the UC.
Right.
Okay. There is two ways there. One is I already created the script command. Okay. What you can do is and press that script command, it will run. Okay, I mean some other location, documents, GitHub. Next level, if I do that command, right, it will run MCS independently. You can see this here, right? Dev packages, CD to dev package, you see. CD to dev packages eco UC dev, then doing the ARN start. Okay. Already the port is using by some other application, that's why it's run in the Trezor Pro actually. This type we can run the model independent. Even I can stop this one. I can go to the dev packages and do ego UC dev and do ARN start. It will also do the same.
Okay. But with the integrated environment only, we should first log in and we should close that tab. I mean, whether we close it or not, so that we get the auth token, right?
You see, that is not needed. If you are running the model independently, means the login page will automatically come actually.
Okay.
So for other model, you have to do that approach actually, whatever I told.
Okay.
Because you see, the client has asked as a separate pipeline. Okay, there right. You because of the POS machine, we have created a separate pipeline. This is the ego. This is a separate pipeline we have created actually. Okay, here we have hosted only the MCS part, miscellaneous collection, mcollect part actually. Here you can see the prod command for mcollect also. You can see here, and go, this is the prod command, command for the MCS, then going here and do the unbuild. Okay, that will run for the production mode actually.
Okay.
I think we stopped 3002, na? We started with the package.
Huh. We stopped and starting again in the same.
Okay.
This is about independent running actually. Okay. Yeah, I will definitely share this modus. Means after these other sessions are completed, right? Tomorrow is one more session is there, right? The mobile app, how to generate the APK. That part is there. That time I will just explain how we can generate the APK and the other part. After all the these sessions are completed, right? You can request for the framework KT. There I will go with the Scratch project actually. Scratch project and how to set up. Means there is a documentation is there, right? This documentation I will go step by step. I will give more idea, and even framework level also I will explain. Framework level little complex actually, because it's a framework. It's like a something like framework actually. I mean, it will understanding it will take actually. Only intermediate React people can take that thing actually. Others it will be a miss. They won't understand that much actually. It's like a high order component and Redux middlewares, those concepts will come.
Okay.
Yeah. Any other questions? Whatever I'm running, right? It's equivalent to this one only. Once it runs, it will show like this only.
Okay. This something like proxy also we set it right in starting. So
proxy. Because why proxy is needed means you are asking for this proxy, right? You see. This proxy, right?
Right.
Because when we are running the application, if the resource is not there in the local, okay, that will return you 404 actually. Okay. For example, if I hard code this mseva URL in my util actually, my util is there, right? The util function of here, if I hard code, okay, if I hard code this URL, what will happen is you will get the cross error actually, cross origin request error.
Okay,
that's why we have to do the proxy in our application. That means this one is proxying to that one actually. Means there is a proxy parameter will go to that endpoint that won't return you the proxy error.
Okay.
Because of that proxy only, you need to set up this one. That will proxy. It depends upon where your microservices are hosted actually. Here I am pointing to mseva, UAT, LG. Might be for your state domain will be there. Okay, that you have to change in your development. State or your VL server domain will be there, right? That that IP address or that domain you have to paste here. Actually.
Okay. Or we can point it to localhost also, something like that.
Localhost, if you are running all the service, you can do
okay, services.
It's okay. It's about backend call actually.
Okay.
It's about backend.
So
yes, we can.
No, that URL path also we have some format. I forgot that because we were checking UI app v2. In that, it's one particular file. It was mentioned in the root folder only. That what and all call we have to make it. In this case, again, it's an individual module only.
No, individual model. When you are calling the HTTP, and you are using HTTP request, this still function, right? There you have to point the endpoint actually. I have mentioned in this one. This function you will call, right? This util function. There you have to mention after domain what should be the endpoint.
So we are defining it there and there. Means wherever the functionality is getting called, at that point only we are defining the endpoint, right?
Yes,
not at some common place.
Yeah, only domain will be mentioned in the common place.
Okay.
That is in the packet.json. After the domain, which microservice you are pointing, that you have to mention explicitly actually, because this is a microservice context path. And this is a version, and this is the path actually, which path you are calling actually.
Okay.
Yeah. It will keep on change actually. MDMS, this is the path, and the UC, something else will be.
Okay. And in mCollect or any trade license, if we are having the multiple step, so that state we are storing in the Redux only, using the Redux only, or any other way? Means next multiple. When we do. For example, mCollect, first you will select the category, then new application.
New application, okay.
And
no,
new collection.
Okay.
You will fill, then again you will do the next. So all this intermediate data we are storing when you do the next.
Yeah. When you click on next, there is some API call will happen. Okay. We call the API and depends upon the API response code. If it is 200 means it will be success. That time we will assume it's a success, and whatever response will come, we'll store it to the Redux. Okay. If it is something other than 200, 201 is fine actually. Other than that, we just throw the exception actually.
So in the first page only you create the some unique ID for this. Means in this case new collection, because it's we didn't do the
yeah. Here only the selecting on the what will happen is first there is a call will call to the billing create demand actually. Okay, it will create a demand. Okay, we will get the demand ID whatever it's there actually. After that we call the API billing service API that will generate the bill actually. First we generate the demand, then bill will generate. Okay, that will show here actually. That will show here the bill. This is the bill. This is the bill. After that, everything bill data is stored, and clicking on this part.
See, now we, again we are having the go back, right? So so that state management, like next if we are having 3-4 step and then we are having the go back, so so
that is clicking on this one only. We will just use that set route action. We'll just put a path actually. It's not stored in the Redux. That will return by developer actually. Clicking on this generate receive, okay. That will return by developer actually, where it has to go. And clicking on this go back, okay. Right. Where it has to go, that will be returned by developer.
Okay, so when we do the go back, it has to again retain the state, right? Because whatever he has filled, it will be filled state only, right? Means the previous form, when he do the go back, means the data was filled. Okay, now it's showing the filled one values, not the emptiest value. So so again, it's a what kind of action? I mean, there was a three kind of action. One is form submit, one is a condition, and one was a page route.
Yeah. See, clicking on the black back button, what will happen is Redux is already having this data actually. Yes. We just came here, right? The component will re-render actually. Okay. Whatever the data is there in the Redux, it will show that data only.
Okay. So it will read from the demand that object. Demand one.
This part anyhow user entry actually. This part is user entry. Okay. And that demands only whatever JSON path we will mention here, that will from there only actually. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. See, now the update is happening actually. Demand update is happening. Okay. Because we came back and edited something. That's why demand update is calling and the generate API. Here we have to mention who is paying, owner is paying, then generate. Okay. Clicking on generate, what will happen is some exception has come. See, some exception came from the API that we will read, that only we will show in the UI actually. Okay. Might be service is not up. Okay. Might be some service problem might be there. Then see, next what will happen, collection service API will call. Okay, collection API, what will happen, what it will do is it will just collect the data means bill means payment means made by the user actually. Demand, then generate bill, and then generate entry of that bill in the collection service. Any other question?
Actually, now we'll go and see that how the code flow is happening. Maybe with that we'll get more clarity.
Okay, we have separate environment. This is the product environment actually. I think you have you got the this credential?
No.
Okay, let me put the here you can play. This is for employee. This is for citizen. Okay, citizen you can register actually. You can, this is a dev environment, product one actually. Whatever release branch is shown, right? Okay, all the new feature will be there here actually. Something like the WhatsApp feature, whatever is recently done. Those feature will be there here. Okay, you can go here for this one. Citizen, you have to register actually. You register first time. Okay, with all the filling this information, you will have your ID. Okay, for employee, I will share the credential actually. I will give you the super admin credential. You can have a look on all the models actually. Whatever there in the digit, you can see all the models. Okay.
Actually, this is very much required because we have to ask the client also what and all things are readily available and what is the difference between existing their application and with the eGov. Okay, So if it's there, it's very much useful.
Which one you are telling?
Means super user. So, means as such, we can see the complete dashboard, what and all functionalities are there.
Yeah, I will give you super. It's the dev environment. Whatever you will crash, no one will worry. Actually, we can regain the state. Actually, no problem. Okay.
Okay.
I will share the credential. Citizen, you have to create.
Okay.
This is a super admin actually. Yeah. This is a super admin. You can log in. Just I will cross check once. Because I am currently working in the Punjab actually. I have my Punjab dashboard is limited. You've seen, right? Punjab employee dashboard was limited.
Right.
This is the product one. One is AMR and another one is whatever I pinged actually. Okay, 128. Okay, AMR and 128. Both are super admin actually.
Okay.
1, 2, 8. And Amritsar sir is a tenant actually. Let's select Amritsar. And okay, this will have all the models. You can play with all the models actually.
Okay.
And citizen you have to create. Here also if you create, you will get all the models.
So POS so option also will get in this? No, not POS.
Citizen will... Citizen will... you will
payment gateway option will be there.
Yeah, payment integration will be there. Okay.
In the payment gateway, yeah. Gateway, when we do this, there's one is production environment. Okay, obviously the transition will be real. In the case of development or UAT case, so how you do the yesterday I saw yesterday or day before yesterday they were doing like something. They were redirecting to the payment gateway page and then they enter some key. With that, it validated and returned back. Without actually doing some real transaction. So
I will share the test credential. Actually, we have the test cards actually for the development and QA. We have the test cards. We'll share you the test cards detail. Okay, you can how much you want. Actually.
Okay, so somewhat it's provided by the payment gateway. I mean the Access Bank and all that, right?
They will only give the test cards detail actually. Then you can do the payment.
Okay.
MCollect is the first model, huh? Which state we are?
No, actually it's for cantonment, army cantonment.
Okay, great.
Okay.
Only Indian Army.
Yeah, Indian Army.
Okay. Anyhow, you can take my Slack ID or whatever. If anything is there, you can ping me if you have any questions. Might be my deployment will delay.
Okay. Yeah, it would be better if you share, just in case something can be like in Slack channel only, if we can ask you something and get the response.
Yeah, recently the BL is added to our channel actually.
That is DevOps.
DevOps, huh? Okay.
DevOps team.
Can you request your UI team to join to Ego front end channel? Means I think some your DevOps has some idea about how to join actually. If you join here, we can have the discussion. If you have any questions on the front end, right?
Yeah.
You can have the discussion here.
Okay. As I remember, this part is actually done by the Gajendra. He specifically made one channel for BL that DevOps related. So if I start writing something engineering part in that channel, it should not be a like.
That's why I'm requesting. If someone from your side has requested that thing, right? Adding that part, DevOps part, right?
Right.
Someone can the same guy can request for adding the adding you your team to the Ego front end channel or somewhere actually, or they can create another new channel for you guys and add me and your team into that channel actually. That
okay.
is also
okay. Okay.
Thank you. Then we can wind up, right?
A motive for the citizen login OTP we have to enter, that's 123456, right? Or we to
is
get
it
on
not
the phone.
Okay, you are not getting that OTP?
No, I'm not getting the OTP.
Okay, some operator is not coming actually. What we can do is you can use my number only. 1 2 3 6. Okay, use this number only if you are who are not getting the this OTP. That is the number and OTP you can use.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay, okay. We can wind up, right?
Yeah. Thanks a lot, Molly. Actually, it was seriously good session. It was very much required session.
Yeah, yeah. Guys, you can request actually after sharing the document, you guys can go through the document 1 week, something next complete week you can take for going this document. And meanwhile, you can ping me also in the Slack channel or whatever my personal, this one is there, right? Ego account is there, right? There also you can ping me. I will reply whatever problem you are facing actually. Okay. After that, we can have a session. Okay. That will, there we can have the, Ego framework, whatever.
Okay. So we won't ping you much, but if you can share your personal Slack ID, then it will be better. Because I don't know how much time it will take to create a particular Slack channel. And we have, actually the point is, we have to showcase this mCollect by 11 June. And there's a lot of problems going on. So.
Okay, you have to modify or just showing the
by default, we as such it means localization part we have to do it as I believe, but again it's not quite clear. Do we have to integrate some other things or this much is sufficient?
Okay, okay, okay. Okay. I think the this is my hangout actually. Slack, I think you can't directly. Communicate I pinged you the Hangout ID.
Okay.
You are using Hangout, right?
Right, right. We are using.
Okay. The backend microservices are up. Means your environment, everything is done by.
Actually, again, that's today 4 o'clock. There was some meeting, so maybe something has come up, or again some problem is there. Not sure on that.
Okay.
So that's why.
What I can do is whoever you want me to add actually. I will create one group actually in the Hangout. Okay.
Uh-huh.
What you can do is I will add the whoever wants to add, I will add here. Okay. BL support group I will create. Okay.
Okay.
Here you can give the IDs. Means whoever wants to add actually. Can you ping me here only? Means I will
yeah, sure. Actually, my Bell office ID doesn't have link with the Google, means
okay.
Google account.
Okay. You are from BL Bangalore?
Bangalore only.
Bangalore, okay. All are from Bangalore, no?
Right.
Okay. And native also Bangalore only?
My native?
Huh.
No, Jaipur.
Okay. Anyone is from Bangalore?
All. Ragni is from, SH from Karnataka. Ragni, Rajni.
I'm from Karnataka only, just I asked.
Okay.
Are you working from office or home?
Yeah, office only. Actually, we are working on 3rd or 4th May, right?
Okay. You are from which place? I'm from Shimoga.
Okay.
Hassan. Yeah. Hassan, okay.
Thanks, man. Seriously.
Okay.
Thank you.
I just adding all the people. I just created the group actually. Let me see. Okay, it's created. Might be you guys also got the invite.
Just a moment.
Bell support.
You got that?
Got it,
Not yet.
Okay.
Maybe after some time. Normally, it should be fast.
I know.
Okay.
Where do you see that in your mobile? No, this is chat room. If there's a chat option in
okay, and even you will have the my email address, right? You can directly ping me or mail me, whatever is there. I think this group is created already. You can check, might be your personal hangout. If you log in, you'll get that group actually.
Okay,
just ping the hi actually. I think over like this. No.
Yeah, got it.
Okay. We can have the discussion here if you have anything.
Right.
Then we are good to wind up, right?
Right.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Pradley.
Yeah.